Question 93.12. Questioner, then presently we receive catalyst to the mind as we are aware of Ra's communication, and we receive catalyst to the body as our bodies sense all of the inputs to them. But could Ra then describe catalyst to the spirit, and are we at this time receiving that catalyst, and if not, could Ra give an example of that? Answer, I am Ra. Catalyst being processed by the body is catalyst for the body. Catalyst being processed by the mind is catalyst for the mind. Catalyst being processed by the spirit is catalyst for the spirit. An individual mind, body, spirit complex may use any catalyst which comes before its notice, be it through the body and its senses or through mediation or through any other more highly developed source in its unique way to form an experience unique to it, with its biases. Question 93.13. Questioner, would I be correct in saying that the archetype for the catalyst of the mind is the logos as model for its most efficient plan for the activity or use of the catalyst of the mind? Answer, I am Ra. Yes. Question 93.14. Questioner, then the adept, in becoming familiar with the logos as archetype in each case, would be able to most efficiently use the logos as plan for evolution. Is this correct? Answer, I am Ra. In the archetypical mind, one has the resource of not specifically a plan for evolution, but rather a blueprint or architecture of the nature of evolution. This may seem to be a small distinction, but it has significance in perceiving more clearly the use of this resource of the deep mind. Question 93.15. Questioner, then Ra presented the images which we know now as the tarot so that the Egyptian adepts of the time could accelerate their personal evolution. Is this correct? And was there any other reason for the presentation of these images by Ra? Answer, I am Ra. You are correct. Question 93.16. Questioner, are there any other uses at all of tarot cards other than the one I just named? Answer, I am Ra. To the student, the tarot images offer a resource for learning teaching the processes of evolution. To any other entity, these images are pictures and no more. Question 93.17. Questioner, I was specifically thinking of the fact that Ra, in an earlier session, spoke of the tarot as a system of divination. Would you tell me what you meant by that? Answer, I am Ra. Due to the influence of the Chaldees, the system of archetypical images was incorporated by the priests of that period into a system of astrologically based study, learning, and divination. This was not the purpose for which Ra developed the tarot. Question 93.18. Questioner, the third card also shows the wand, I am assuming it is, in the right hand. The ball atop the wand is the round magical shape. Am I in any way correct in guessing that the catalyst of the mind suggests the possible eventual use of the magic depicted by this wand? Answer, I am Ra. The wand is astrological in its origin and as an image may be released from its stricture. The sphere of spiritual power is an indication indeed that each opportunity is pregnant with the most extravagant magical possibilities for the far-seeing adept. Question 93.19. Questioner, the fact that the clothing of the entity is transparent indicates the semi-permeability of the veil for the catalytic process. Is this correct? Answer, I am Ra. We again must pause. 15-second pause. I am Ra. We continue under somewhat less than optimal conditions. However, due to the nature of this instrument's opening to us, our pathway is quite clear and we shall continue. Because of pain flares, we must ask you to repeat your last query. Question 93.20. Questioner, I was just wondering if the transparency of the garments on the third card indicates the semi-permeable nature of the veil between the conscious and unconscious mind? Answer, I am Ra. This is a thoughtful perception and cannot be said to be incorrect. However, the intended suggestion, in general, is an echo of our earlier suggestion that the nature of catalyst is that of the unconscious, that is, outward catalyst comes through the veil. All that you perceive seems to be consciously perceived. This is not the correct supposition. All that you perceive is perceived as catalyst unconsciously. By the, shall we say, time that the mind begins its appreciation of catalyst, that catalyst has been filtered through the veil and in some cases much is veiled in the most apparently clear perception. Question 93.21. Questioner, I'm at a loss to know the significance of the serpents that adorned the head of the entity on this drawing. Are they of Ra, and, if so, what do they stand for? Answer: I am Ra. They are cultural in nature. In the culture to which these images were given, the serpent was the symbol of wisdom. Indeed, to the general user of these images, perhaps the most accurate connotation of this portion of the concept complexes might be the realization that the serpent is that which is powerful magically. In the positive sense, this means that the serpent will appear at the indigo ray site upon the body of the image figures. When a negative connotation is intended, one may find the serpent at the solar plexus center. Question 93.22. Questioner: is there any significance to the serpent? Is there any polarity to the serpent as we experience it in this illusion? Answer: I am Ra. We assume that you question the serpent as used in these images rather than the second density life form, which is a portion of your experience. There is a significance to the serpent form in a culture which coexists with your own but which is not your own, that is, the serpent is symbol of that which some call the Kundalini and which we have discussed in previous material. Question 93.23. Questioner: is there any other aspect of this third card that Ra could comment on at this time? Answer: I am Ra. There may be said to be many aspects which another student might note and ponder in this image. However, it is the nature of teach learning to avoid trespass into the realms of learned teaching for the student. We are quite agreed to comment upon all observations that the student may make. We cannot speak further than this for any student. We would add that it is expected that each student shall naturally have an unique experience of perception dealing with each image. Therefore, it is not expected that the questioner ask comprehensively for all students. It is, rather, expected and accepted that the questioner will ask a moiety of questions which build up a series of concepts concerning each archetype, which then offer to each succeeding student the opportunity for more informed study of the archetypical mind. May we ask for one more query at this time? We are pleased to report that this instrument has remembered to request the reserving of some transferred energy to make more comfortable the transition back to the waking state. Therefore, we find that there is sufficient energy for one more query. Question 93.24. Questioner: I am assuming that you mean one full question. I'll make that question in this form. I'd like to know the significance of the shape of the crux and zeta, and if that's too much of an answer, I'll just ask if there is anything that we can do to make the instrument more comfortable or to improve the contact? Answer: I am Ra. They are mathematical ratios within this image which may yield informative insights to one fond of riddles. We shall not untangle the riddle. We may indicate that the crux and zeta is a part of the concept complexes of the archetypical mind, the circle indicating the magic of the spirit, the cross indicating the nature of manifestation which may only be valued by the losing. Thus the crux and zeta is intended to be seen as an image of the eternal in and through manifestation and beyond manifestation through the sacrifice and the transformation of that which is manifest. The support group functions well. The swirling waters experienced by the instrument since our previous working have substantially aided the instrument in its lessening of the distortion of pain. All is well. The alignments are well guarded. We leave you, my friends, in the love and the light of the Infinite One. Go forth, therefore, rejoicing in the power and in the peace of the One Infinite and Glorious Creator. Adonai.